And joining us in the studio this morning is Labor Secretary Silvestre Bello III. Welcome to Hot Coffee. Thank you for coming to Head Start.
Thank you, ma'am.
All right, so you have issued a memo, the Department of Labor. And tell us, because you have businessmen watching, I mean, should companies be scared already? What does the memo entail?
Well, they should not be afraid, Karen, because all that our labor inspectors will be doing is to see the records of their employments. Gusto namin masiguro na ito yung mga regular employees na. Kasi kadalasan, may mga employees who are hired only for, let's say, for a period of 5 months, after which nawawala na sila.
Mm-mm.
Then they're rehired.
But how would you trust or how would you ensure that the companies will be keeping honest and clean records of employees? Like, for example, you send someone to investigate or check, and then you can have a company not include the names of other people that they, let's say, repeatedly hire for only 5 months. How would you know that?
Well, we can have this validated by talking also to the employees themselves.
Will they cooperate?
I think so. It's for their interest after
all.
So, ganun lang. Ask them, ano ba ang nature of your employment? Ilang buwan na kayo dito? Ilang taon na kayo dito? Eh, pag sinabi nila na, let's say, I have been here for about 1 year, pero putol-putol. Ganun. That's an example of Endo system.
Mm-mm. But then those that are victimized also by Endo, sir, after 5 months, halimbawa, you're a messenger, you'll be fired every 5 months, so you have to keep looking for another job. How can you track companies that do this?
The employees themselves. Yeah, they will tell you na I was laid off for 1 month or 2 months, and then after 2 months, we are rehired.
That's just
to prevent their becoming regular employees.
Okay. And what would the punishment be? How would you penalize a company that is proven to be practicing end of contract?
Well, actually, we don't want to go to that extent, Karen. And what we would do is talk to the management. Why don't you make them regulars? After all, you need them. You have trained them for 5 months and another 5 months, so they're already good in the business, so why don't you hire them regularly?
Mm-hmm.
But if, siyempre, alam mo kung matigas ang ulo, then that's when we impose sanction.
So where do we draw the line? I think, let's start with this. Let's say it's a big mall. It's a big department store. I've heard one business person say, if everyone is regularized, what would happen is they would have to do with, let's say, 7 salespeople. But because many are not regularized, they are able to hire 15 or 20. Mm. So now you have a question of two issues.
Balancing.
Do you regularize? Because a regularization costs more. So then you hire less. Or do you contractualize when you could definitely regularize,
more,
but then you give more jobs? Where is the line?
I don't think, Karen, that's exactly true. Because, you know, a business needs employees. The number also depends on the nature of the business. So hindi yung ano, hindi yung sinasabi nila na pagka regular babawasan namin. I don't think that's true because kukuha ka ng employees mo, that is needed by the nature of your business. Ang ayaw lang kasi nila na magkaroon ng ano, ng they pass through the probationary period after 6 months, they become regulars. Medyo natatakot lang sila, but that's a very wrong notion on the part of management. Na kapag yung employee becomes regular, nagiging pasaway. You know, they join unions. Mm-hmm. You know, so it's